There is a debate that has raged since the beginning of PC building. What is the right way to apply thermal paste to your CPU? Well, today we aim to put that debate to rest.
I know this topic comes up between you and I every single time we build a PC.
That's right, the argument over the best application design, whether it's a pea sized dot, a line, or a star pattern for applying thermal paste has been debated probably ever since people have been putting thermal paste on processors.
So what is our plan for testing which one's better?
Well, I'm glad you asked. We have devised a solution that will not only test coverage by design, but will also show us what the actual application looks like on a heatsink when pressure is applied. And here is how we're gonna do it. Let's look at our setup for testing. Using quarter inch plexiglass cut with our Glowforge laser cutter, we're going to emulate a motherboard and a CPU that we've sandwiched between the heatsink and its heatsink mounting bracket. This is our motherboard stand-in. This piece has holes cut to allow the heatsink mounting bracket to pass through to the heatsink that will mount above. We've etched a location out in the center to guarantee that our CPU piece will always be in the same location each time and not move around. Let's look at our plexiglass CPUs. The plexiglass CPU pieces are 60 by 60 millimeter, quarter inch thick, with special etchings on one side to indicate both the IHS of an AMD Ryzen CPU and the new Intel 12th Gen CPU. The thermal paste will be applied to the top of the plexiglass CPU, nested into the etch spot on the plexiglass motherboard, and the heatsink will be screwed to the heatsink mounting bracket, sandwiching together the parts. Thanks to our clear plexiglass CPUs, we'll be able to see exactly what sort of coverage we're gonna get. For our testing, we'll be using the Noctua NHU12A cooler. We've chosen this cooler because 1, we had it on hand, and 2, it has a fantastically large base plate that easily covers both the AMD IHS and the Intel 12th Gen IHS. And 3, it's just a damn fine heatsink. And for thermal paste, we'll be using Arctic's MX4, which is our go-to paste for the PC builds we make here at the channel.
We reached out to our YouTube subscribers and asked them how they apply thermal paste, and we've taken those into account in our testing. Here's a list of the test patterns. Number 1, of course, the pea-sized dot starts off our group. This is the most widely commented and used application, and the one we use when we build our PCs. Next is the star pattern, which seems logical, if not a bit complicated to apply. Not to be outdone, we've got the X pattern representing. Number 4, how about 3 parallel lines? Yeah, why not? Next, rounding out our line patterns, we present the humble single line. 6th, we'll test a unique 5-dot pattern, which incidentally is known as a quincunx, a word that just rolls off the tongue. Number 7 is the full spread. Insert not safe for work joke here. And lastly, number 8, the smiley face, just to bring you a little joy.
Here's a visual of our testing apparatus. First, we'll add the thermal paste on top of our acrylic CPU, add the CPU to our acrylic motherboard, and screw down the heatsink. As we screw down the heatsink, the pressure is applied just as it would be when mounting the heatsink into your PC. Once we free the HSF from the mounting bracket, we can see the results through the clear plexi CPU and see the AMD and Intel etchings showing where the outer edges of the respective IHS are. Now, let's get to the results.
Starting off with a humble pea. The pea did not produce that great of coverage. Most of the AMD IHS was covered, but left bare areas around the edges. The coverage was even worse for the Intel due to the increased length of the 12th Gen IHS, which left even more areas bare. Considering this is how we've been applying thermal paste for years, it looks like we need to change our methods.
Now, onto the star pattern. The star had fantastic coverage with a bit too much overage on both the AMD and the Intel IHS, but overall, both were very well covered. The star pattern did feel like a bit of an excessive use of thermal paste, however, the coverage speaks for itself.
Now let's look at the X pattern. Again, fantastic coverage as well, but with considerably less overage. Considering the design uses less thermal paste and was easier to apply, we'd say the X pattern beats out the star pattern on overall thermal paste usage, had less overage, but also had slightly less coverage for both IHSs.
What about the three-line design? The three lines stunned us, frankly. The three-line design had the best coverage of the line design so far, with complete coverage on both AMD and Intel's IHSs. It does, however, have a fair bit of overage, but out of the 4 designs tested so far, it's the winner. Very nice.
Now on to the single line. In a case of no one being surprised, the single line design pattern was complete trash and nobody should use it. Coverage was poor for both AMD and Intel CPUs, and it was the worst of all tested so far. Even the dot had better coverage.
Before asking our viewers for thermal paste pattern suggestions, we had never heard of the 5-dot pattern, and from our testing, It's clear this pattern did not produce great results, and it kind of looks like a petri dish. The design left large uncovered areas of both IHSs, and having dots in the outer edges of the IHS area meant more overage and wasted thermal paste. It's clear that the pattern doesn't produce quality results, and we'd recommend against using it.
Next was the full coverage pattern, and as expected, the results knocked it out of the park. With fantastic edge-to-edge coverage with a small amount of overage, the full coverage pattern by far is the best performing thermal paste application. The only downside to this pattern was the time it took to apply it evenly. But if you're building a PC and you want to do it right the first time, this is your pattern, and you can rest easy knowing you've got great coverage.
Yes, just for fun, the smiley face. And surprisingly enough, it did a pretty good job at covering both the AMD and the Intel IHSs. With a few areas not covered and a little overage, really, no one is going to apply thermal paste this way, but if they did, it's nice to know it wouldn't be a complete disaster.
Here's one last look at all of the slides together to give you a quick comparison between them. Again, first place goes to the full coverage pattern. Second place goes to the three-line pattern. Third place going to the star pattern, and an honorable mention going to the X pattern.
Let's look at the slides more closely. Out of the top four, we felt that the full coverage design had the best adhesion. Removing the acrylic CPU from the heatsink was difficult, which told us that the adhesion between the two was fantastic, and we think that's also visible by the number of little peaks of thermal paste left on the CPU after removal. The designs with fewer peaks when removed had poorer adhesion and were easier to remove. Looking over the three other winning designs, all of them had increased peaks and adhesion points versus the designs that exhibited less coverage.
This has been an eye-opener for us. In the past, we always used a pea-sized dot when building our systems, and it's clear that method is not the best way of applying thermal paste. It stands to be said that if you're looking for the best coverage between your CPU and heatsink, nothing beats a full spread. For those of you in a hurry, the three-line method is faster and provides almost the same results. We'd love to hear from you out there on what methods you use, and maybe we'll make an updated video testing those different patterns as well. And now check out this video right here where John and I review the Fantex T3120 fan and compare it to the Noctua NF-A12x25 to see if it can dethrone the King of Quiet.